Most pregnant women, when they become infected with Zika virus, have no symptoms. About 4 out of every 5 women that are infected will never know they're infected. 1 in 5 may develop some fever, a rash, red eyes, joint pain. The problem what we've discovered in pregnant women is that the virus can actually cross the placenta and infect their baby. So the babies, depending on when the woman gets infected, may end up developing microcephaly, which is a very small head, and the brain development may actually be very abnormal. It does. Like a lot of viruses that end up affecting pregnant women, the earlier on in pregnancy that they become infected, the more likely they are to have obvious abnormalities in the fetus, because that's the time where the fetus is doing the most of its development. We do believe pregnant women are at risk throughout the pregnancy. We know that infections that have crossed the placenta and actually affected the babies can occur at any time during pregnancy. It just depends on when in pregnancy they're infected as to what the effects are that we're going to see. Right now, we know that Zika virus will cross the placenta and may affect a baby. The problem is we have so limited data that we don't know how many women will actually infect their baby if they themselves become infected. What the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, or the CDC, have come out saying is that if you have been infected either in a previous pregnancy or long before you become pregnant, we don't think there will be an effect on the current pregnancy. I do believe they should avoid travel, if at all possible. Until we know more about how this virus affects all pregnant women, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, American College of OB-GYN, Society of Maternal Fetal Medicine are all recommending that pregnant women limit travel to affected areas. If you are pregnant and you have traveled to a Zika-affected area, immediately notify your obstetrician, because there are guidelines out there right now put out by the CDC, by the American College of Obstetrics and Gynecology, and the Society for Maternal Fetal Medicine that have all come together and developed guidelines for how the obstetrician should evaluate you, should evaluate the baby, and do all the testing. We know how long the virus takes to infect a person. We think we know how long the virus stays in a pregnant woman, though we're still trying to make sure that number is correct. It can be transmitted sexually. There have been several cases reported in the literature that have discussed male to female transmission. There still have not been any cases reported of a female infecting a male through sexual transmission. If your partner has traveled and you have not, and you are pregnant, what we are recommending is abstaining from sexual intercourse. If you do have sexual intercourse, make sure you're using condoms consistently and correctly. If you are pregnant and you do have unprotected sexual intercourse, make sure you notify your obstetrician because they may need to do an evaluation.